We expend our time and energy on things that are of no eternal value at all. Can I tell you today, preacher friend, that the church is not in the computer business. The church is not in the building business. The church is not in the pew and the carpet business. The church is not in the bus and van business. The church is not in the fundraising business or the music business or the fellowship business. Brother Haney, we're not even in the organization business. I gotta tell somebody today that the business of the church is souls. I said the business of the church is souls. I know you believe in the rapture of the church. I know you believe that the trumpet's going to sound. And I know that you believe that it couldn't be long now until that great event takes place. But can I tell you that when the trumpet sounds, this beautiful building we're in today isn't going up in the rapture. That padded pew you're sitting on, that great keyboard and that organ and this PA system and all of our high-tech toys, none of it's going up in the rapture. If you want your life to count, if you want the time that you spend to have eternal value attached to it, then you're going to have to invest your time in souls. Somebody say hallelujah. I watched as Brother Mangan paraded in what looked like about 150 street kids last night, and they stood all over this platform, and I sat there and thought to myself, I'd rather stand on the judgment day with about 30 or 40 street kids behind me. I'd rather stand on judgment day before God with a busload of sinners standing behind me and say, God, this is where I invested my time. God, this is what was most important to me. In Matthew 16 and 26, Jesus asked the question, for what is a man profited if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? With that one short piercing question, Jesus Christ reveals to us the worth of a single soul. To God, one soul is worth more than all of this world. Stack up on the one side of the balance the combined wealth of the world, all of the gold, silver, all of its jewels and its precious stones. Stack up its most magnificent homes, its luxury automobiles, its yachts, and its airplanes. And on the other side of that balance, place just one single soul. And in God's economy, that one soul is going to tip the scale every time, because one soul matters more to God than all the world. Somebody shout hallelujah. Come to tell you today, it doesn't matter to God if that soul is a black man, a Hispanic man, an Asian man, or a white man. It doesn't matter to God if that soul's rich or poor, educated or uneducated. It doesn't matter to God if that soul's a somebody or by society's standards a nobody. One soul, any soul, matters more to God than all of this world.